Listening to Social Misconduct with Mik and B. Walt, only on LA Talk Radio.
Everybody. Hey, everybody.
Hey, everybody.
How
what's
y'all?
What's up with the mic? I couldn't hear myself at first. I was like, wait, I can't hear.
I was Shane.
Welcome back to Social Misconduct. I am your girl, Mik, and I'm here with my co-host, B. Walt.
Hey, y'all.
And we have a special guest today, the crazy, hilarious.
B. Walt in the house, a.k.a. Ray Grady.
Ray Grady. Okay. Not B. Walt, a.k.a. Ray Grady.
Why?
You're so stupid.
That's my man. I ain't seen him in a minute.
I'm going to start going places. I'm Grady.
Yeah, there you go. I'm like, how you doing? I'm B.
Walt. World famous like comedian, Grady.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to be like, look, world famous radio host. This jockey.
You're way more famous than we are.
Exactly.
So.
Exactly.
So
those of you that have been following us, when we were just doing radio and audio, Grady was on our show a while ago. When we first started back at Accelerated, Grady was a guest. But now that we're on video, we needed to have him back. So welcome.
I appreciate y'all letting me come up here, man.
Welcome to LA Talk Radio. As you can see, we moved on up.
Yeah. It's
you know,
clean in here.
I can't with that.
Except for the lady that got on the elevator.
What lady?
And I was like, whoa, is that you?
I can't. What did she stink?
Stink. You can just tell, you know. Anytime you hug somebody and that little woof
and
on
that
your chest,
and that, like, that space in between,
you just gotta be
the
like,
air.
You got you. Just kind of be like, you ain't do.
It's like an odor just
you
coming from the boob area.
Exactly.
Yeah,
you know, from the
you.
Navel to.
Mm-hmm.
And this what you, instead of saying you stink and you smell, you be like, you so very not satisfactory right about now.
Very
you see that?
Not
you see
satisfactory.
That? So it's so, you don't even know. They don't even feel.
Insulted.
Right, they just be like, dang.
Okay, how do you react to that?
Well, how do we react to your stench? Okay, that's what you, that's that's how you have to do them. You
do
them like that.
Your hug air, though.
But all I know, it's. Let me tell you something. You know when you're moving up, they had a cone outside in my parking spot.
Holding your
so
spot,
I,
homie.
Man, I felt like I need six niggas with me.
You need an entourage.
Security, yep. I started dancing in the hallway when I got before waiting on the elevator. Go downstairs and see the motherfucking camera. You'll see me getting my jig on right there. Bop.
That's the dance right there?
Well,
I mean, I'll do it for y'all whenever, but that was kind of that.
He be ready to bust out this dance. I'll be trying to tame it, though.
You got to have fun. Me, it's really me and my niece started. We just danced against each other.
My God.
Shout out to Brenda.
That ain't her real
name.
No,
that's what I call
it. Just so y'all know.
Yeah,
that ain't
my niece.
So if you hear him refer to someone named Vil, that would be me.
That would be you.
That's my nickname that
Vil.
Grady calls me. So
yeah, you because it's almost.
Y'all smart. Follow along.
Yeah, because I can't call Makia. A lot of people be like Makiva, Makia. It's too much. I'd be like Vil.
People here know me as Mik, but you call me whatever you want to. We good. We good. We want you comfortable. You at home.
So your name, Mik. That's Grady, and I'm B-Walt. That's
how
we gonna do.
That's going to confuse the shit
out
of me.
I'm Grady today.
That's the voice. That's that rough voice.
I'm a little follicularly inadequate, though. This nigga got a beard like a motherfucker.
You heard that big word.
Oh, wait.
That
sounds a little
too
smart. That's too smart.
Well, that's kind of like loquacious. Shout out to Tiff, 215.
I can't.
That's my barber. I was like, yeah, you being loquacious. Yeah, he'd be like, what? Shout out 215. I don't even say it. He'd be like, what?
What?
Yeah. I said, it's the name of your barber shop. He was like, who you with? I'm like, I'm with 718. But shit, it's too
many.
But
215,
yeah,
it's too many numbers.
Yeah.
Okay, I got you. So what's been going on with you? You're in a commercial.
Yeah.
You know, you all fancy and shit.
Well, I think that was, I think that I blame my manager for me staying there. Because I was about to leave the agency. I was really
not
about
blame.
To leave.
Blame. No, blame is the wrong word. Because
no,
you're in a fucking commercial.
I was about to leave them. I was really about to leave them.
But
I
that's
was,
a good thing that you did not. And
yeah,
like,
that's what
in,
I was saying. I was saying like, yo, she held it down.
You
I
got
like,
a good manager to push that.
Well, I mean, you know.
So what's the commercial?
It's a Kaiser Permanente. And when I went in for the audition, they just said it's for Kaiser, right? So it was like wheatgrass. Anybody have a problem with wheatgrass? And I was like, well, I don't know what that is until you smell it.
I've had a wheatgrass shot, and it is disgusting.
Not five in a row, though. Not five in a row.
Oh. I was high. Five of them motherfuckers?
Because they had to keep doing takes, and you had,
I was high as shit. I would never do that again.
And it was real wheatgrass.
Real. But like when you see the commercial again.
And I see you taking the shots with the guy, in the commercial.
If you look, like, pause it. Like, pause it, look at my face. I'm like this, like, Jesus Christ. Hurry the fuck up.
Yeah,
so I had
gross.
To tell the dude, I was like, listen, I'm not taking no more of these.
Oh,
so the girl in the back, she said, oh, no. She, I don't know if she was a PA or something, producer or somebody. She was like, yo, have you ever had it before? And I was like, baby, where you at? And she had to come and stand in front of me, right? So the other actor, his name was John, he was real cool. So he was like, you straight? I was like, nigga, who are you? I got mad. I got so mad because I was feeling nauseous. You know when you feeling nauseous?
Yeah, especially from that many wheatgrass.
And they was like, all right, do it again. And I was like, whoa, this smell like grass. Is this real grass?
B, have you had wheatgrass?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's gross.
And I saw what it was sitting there. That just didn't look.
But that was real grass.
It's real grass, and then so they put it through to get the juice from
you
the
smell. Yeah. Right? You smell it when you take the shot. And then you smell the grass here. So I was fucked up for about an hour. But I handled it like a trooper. You don't even know it. We had to do the dap, hand clap, point to the camera, take the shot. And I think I probably messed it up.
And it's tied in with the NBA too, right?
Steph Curry.
Yeah.
Steph Curry. Like, he's like the new,
MVP.
So once I'm going to do some promo in Oakland for the show May 9th, and I get a text. So my man, I just seen you on ABC. I'm like, no, you didn't. So I'm driving, and then I get another text from my man Clint Lewis.
So people like seeing.
And he's like, yo, I see you. I'm like, no, I don't have no. They like, nigga, we just seen you with Steph Curry. I was like, I ain't with no. Death, I think it's coming.
We're
like
gonna
that.
Post so, it on our Instagram and our site.
It was cool, man. They I knew I had it because when I went to the callback, he just was like, he just gave me the nod, like, yeah, leave him alone. He was like, let him do his thing. And I was like, for real? So me and the actor that gave us, I went in with three people. I went in with an Indian cat, this white dude, and then this tall 6'7" brother. And he was real cool. He was cool. Me and the brother, I thought me and him was going to get it. But then the white boy came. He was like, let's do it, man. Public fist. And they was like, let him go. So they just let us have fun.
Good.
Yeah, that was fun, though. It was
so nice. You know that, like, Tone Bell and Roy Wood Jr. and Omar Dorsey were guests.
I don't like none of them.
Shut up. They love you. They, like shouted you out on air.
Serious?
For
one,
only Tone Bell was supposed to be here, and he brought along, like, Omar and Roy, and it was just, like, insane. But we weren't on video yet, and I hate that. But we were on audio or whatever, and it was just funny because Roy he said something on your Instagram.
Yeah, I saw
on
it.
The
I
picture.
I texted like, you piece of shit. I just texted you piece of
about
shit.
About the wheatgrass shot. Yeah, he's like, I'm telling Chicago.
I saw that shit too.
Wheatgrass?
Yeah, yeah.
so
that's when you know you're in a different caliber because I couldn't get no comics that I fuck with. Like, let's go do the radio show.
Yeah.
So Tone is like Omar's little brother in the business, right? And then Roy is everybody's. He's OG.
Roy, I mean,
if Roy would say you funny,
yeah,
you can go attack the world. If nobody,
we just let them take over the show because, they came in.
Put it like this:
like,
Roy
killed.
Get to Chicago and he calls me out of everybody in his phone. He called me, said, "Yo, I need a haircut." I said, "Where you at?" He said, "I'm doing stand up down the street from Zany." So I was like, "All right, go see my man on 103rd and Halsted." Text my man Leray. I was like, Leray, Roy Wood Jr. coming through. You know that piece of shit went? He went to 103rd on GPS.
He a real dude.
And he called me. He was like, nigga, how many niggas in here outside? And they selling dope. I was like, you straight. You straight.
Like
don't worry about nothing. So my man Ray called me. He was like, yo, he tipped him well. And I was like, nah, give him, you know, whatever. He was like, he tried to get his cut free. He was like, yo, Grady said I'm supposed to see you. And he was like, you know, and I was like, yeah, nigga, so you owe me, you motherfucker.
You hear that?
Roy, is that the camera right there? You owe me, motherfucker.
So stupid.
Nah, but Tone, I got a lot of respect for a little bro. Omar Dorsey, he, you know, he saw the shit that I was going through over at CBS when they was trying to, you know, you've been there, Viv.
Yeah, I've been there with you.
But shout out to CBS. But Omar was like, you're going to be all right. So that was cool.
Yeah, no, that was a fun show. Mm-hmm. Tell us about the show coming up in, what, Friday, right?
Saturday.
I got my days mixed.
No, it's
May 9th. May 9th in Oakland.
In Oakland, E1 Comedy Club. Nick Carthan, Jay Richards, the host, Takara, and my man Chicago's own Ballhead Hustle Phillips is on the show.
It's going to be a good show.
Yeah, they better bring it.
They better bring it.
Oakland is.
Well, you're headlining, and it's your birthday.
It is?
Really?
Wow, it is.
I can't.
Fuck yeah, it's my birthday. Yes. So, we're going to have some fun, man. I'm excited to see what. Here's the thing about stand-up comics. Comics be like, I want to get on the road. And I be like, you sure?
Right.
Because this shit is
they
no joke.
I don't know if they get into it.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I've been with you for a few years now. So I know.
People that say they funny, I was like, when you leave L.A., because L.A. is a different continent. When you leave L.A., you carry your ass to Ontario, you be like, holy shit. Yeah. These people be like, man, that shit don't work down here. So they was like, you know, Tiff. We're going to see if Tiff can get us on the show. I was like, don't ask me shit. Go through Tiff, go through your manager. I just don't want the local cats on the show like that, you know what I mean? Because I think that they see them enough. So, and I think why not, instead of giving you so much wordplay and learning and all that, take your ass on the road, see how it feel to bomb, you know? Because that's what, if cats be like, oh, I'm going to come out there and I'm going to kill, like, no, Oakland is rough.
That's a yeah.
Oakland does not care.
It's not a city to fuck around with.
Put it like this: I did the Shaq joint, and at Tommy T's, right? And the chick that they was, you know, pumping, they was like, "Yo, you know, this old girl from last comic," and they was like,
"Damn."
It was
that's
rough.
The treatment they gave.
It was rough.
All right.
It was rough. And then I had to headline that. Damn. I had to go behind them. Listen to her and they.
But you kill though, so.
Oh, man. You know what? I think it is. Like even when I talk to my publicist Ville, my manager Tiffany Hubbard. The different shit is this: everybody is. They don't know stand up is very hard.
Yeah.
This is a hard beast because
it's just
we don't have dancers. We don't have. Backup
singers.
It's just you and the mic and the crowd, and they really looking at your outfit. Okay, it's the weirdest shit ever. When you go up on stage, right? Because remember when you first saw me, you saw me in a hole in the wall.
I did.
Right?
Yep.
It wasn't that many people. We had the grand piano on stage.
She looked
at a Tiff like, "Are you fucking serious? Is that a fucking grand piano? And these niggas in here, you know what I mean?" And the stage was big, but the lights weren't shit, right? They had a big-ass balloon spider.
Balloon, yeah.
Right?
I remember because it was around Halloween, I think.
So, Ron, she just kept looking at me like, really? Like, I was like, hey, I don't know. I ain't got nothing to do with this. Come, you just here. Check it out. You see if you like my shit? Cool. Because I was really trying to get her to, you know, come on, let me roll with you. You know, that type of shit. So, you seen it. And how many people you laughed at? Exactly.
He
and,
was looking at me like, so none of this funny.
None of it's funny.
So I'm like, you funny.
She was like, when you going up? I said, I'm last. She was like, I bet. But
I laughed the whole time.
You had the whole time. I could hear her way. I'm on the stage. I could hear her way in the back.
Grady funny as hell. Y'all about to find out. So
we
ready to have some fun.
Hell though. Yeah. Let's go.
We got to get into these stories though.
Let's do it.
All right. You remember the rundown.
Gotcha.
So. Right. That's last. Follow your notes right here, homie.
Bet. All right.
We don't give you, we don't give you the stories. We just give you the topic and you just roll.
Right.
You
I'm
roll
sorry.
With us.
You're right. I'm sorry.
So B found this one. I don't know this person. I'm going to just let you start this time
because
I don't know Jermaine.
Because we talked already. We want to hear you, sexy boy.
NFL star Jermaine Cunningham to appear in court on revenge porn charges.
Okay.
You know what that is, right?
I don't know what revenge.
I didn't know revenge porn was
that shit
a thing.
Is real shit. Yeah, it's real
what,
shit.
What's like, revenge?
Revenge porn?
Porn
is basically when you take somebody you used to fuck with and you plaster all their new photos, videos, and shit on some site.
Like social media or blogs.
Revenge is the word.
Revenge porn.
So it's a thing. Like it's a name.
But
for
this
it.
Is a thing. This is a thing. He ain't posted on those sites. He was passing that shit out to this chick's family.
And friends.
Her head was bananas and she broke up with him.
That's just, like, so petty, though. So she had bad head and
she said it was bananas.
Oh, it was good.
Great
good.
Head.
Oh, so it was good head, but she broke up, so he was mad. Yeah, I got you.
Bitter.
I got you.
He did a broad move.
Because that was some petty ass
shit.
Yeah,
you don't do no shit like that. Like, shout out to any man that get your feelings hurt. So,
so wait, does
what?
He still play? No, it says former New York Jets linebacker, so he don't play anymore.
And
right?
Linebackers are usually gorillas.
He looked like a gorilla.
They usually. That was me.
Well, okay, he don't.
Yeah,
I was just saying. I'm just yeah, come on. All right, let's just speak the truth. It's social misconduct. You know what we do here. Though. Big ass neck, that
damn.
Head. Just yeah, he ain't cute. So he's facing cute? Charges, right?
Yeah.
For this shit, this is like serious shit. And like
what's
Jersey,
the, what's the charges? I mean, how many are they trying to give him, years or a fine or?
Man, it's gonna be a fine.
Yeah, it won't be like.
I mean,
jail.
If it is,
like,
it'd be like maybe you know a little bit of. Time in a jail, he ain't going to prison.
But they're using him as an example because he's a former NFL player. People know his name, so you know they're using him like, oh, this is serious. We're cracking
down.
But
they didn't do that
when
Ben Roethlisberger did his dirt. Exactly.
I don't know these.
Exactly.
The rapist quarterback.
The rapist quarterback.
Oh, okay.
Exactly.
You know what I'm talking about?
Well, they're starting with him.
Yeah.
So, yeah, revenge porn is a thing, people. Don't do it.
I don't. You know what? But we used to shit like that. You know, and
who used to shit like
well,
that?
Like in.
Well, I ain't sending no goddamn news.
No. So. I'm saying like
fuck
we,
all that. I don't trust nobody.
This some. You could tell he didn't hang. You could tell he didn't hang really when he got money. He stopped hanging with. The hood.
Oh, I got you.
Because people that's in the hood don't do shit like that. You know what I mean? That's
yeah,
like
that's some bitch shit.
Yeah, that's like, that's messy. Ooh. That's he got some bread and you know he kept the dreads to you know hang with the the different
in the off season.
Oh,
yeah, exactly.
My God.
And
mm-hmm.
you know she got that fire.
What you gonna send it to her? Her mama? Her mama got this picture though, homie. Come
that
on,
ain't, that ain't even smart, man. That ain't
like,
even smart.
Why would you? You because
even the chicks that he want to deal with that he like. He can't get them. They like, oh, man,
right.
You tell.
Right. Like, who? Why would I do, like, fuck with you now?
We
like,
can't go face to face.
Yeah, like, why would I even fuck with you now?
He is a former NFL player. He might have some stacks, so they might want him to do that because they thinking that's a payday. Go ahead.
True.
Pull.
That's only if the broad is smart enough to do a tell-all book, and she got to go through everybody.
And the thing is, yeah, he ain't really big enough.
That's or it's right. A matter.
He could
yeah.
be like one on a list of like 15 NFL dick she sucked, but just
you
the stupid. First one, it, no.
Wouldn't matter.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
What was the chick that did the tell-all first?
Who Karen
was
Stevens.
Yeah.
Superhead.
Yeah,
Superhead.
That's
we
how
know
everybody
her
knows.
As Superhead.
Oh, yeah. You know, she was doing those classes at Hustler on Santa Monica. She got a real class on giving
oh, she's trying to extend this whole 15 minutes of fame. Like
she's done porn. She's been in a couple.
She
porn.
Did have a bestseller in a book. Like I ain't mad at her for that.
She had a bestseller.
Yeah.
See how
I read that book from cover to motherfucking cover. I ain't gonna lie.
You read
hell
it?
Hell yeah, I read it.
Was it well written?
Was it
well written?
Well, you know she ain't write it. Come on.
What was it? Well written.
Yeah.
She was exposing names and all that.
Oh, she said names. Yes.
Oh, wow.
Anyway, we ain't gonna get at her more. Wrong. We ain't giving her more attention than gotcha. She already got. So, a school district in Hawkins County, mm-hmm. which is
where that's at, G.
That's what I'm trying. Knoxville.
Tennessee.
So, the school district there discovered that they were serving children pork that was frozen 5 years ago, back in 2009.
See, that's. This
it's just
the
been
reason.
Frozen since 2009, and they serving this to these kids, right?
So this is the reason why you should do homeschool. That shit right there. They,
5 years, homie? Like, you going to serve my kid old-ass pork? Oh, no.
Pork that's, at that.
The fuck was the lunch
pork.
Lady
pork.
Doing? Don't y'all got to clean that shit out
like,
of there?
Yeah, you can smell that. Even, you know, stuff that's been in the freeze, you can smell
ugh,
it. Yeah, you can
gross.
Smell it. Yeah. After anything after 90 days.
But whatever. The U.S. Department of Agriculture was saying, like, oh, as long as it's been frozen, it's fine.
For 9 years? Five years?
Like, they're like, oh, it's safe to eat. I mean, you shouldn't be serving this, but it's okay.
But so you know whose fault that is?
Who?
You know whose fault that is, right? Who would y'all say? Who would you say, B?
I'm telling you. I'm blaming the lunch lady. She
okay. Who would you say, Bill? I'm going to tell you whose fault that is. Who would you say?
Whoever is in the lunchroom.
Really?
Yeah.
All right. Now let's take it all the way to the top. That lady wasn't getting paid right.
So this is revenge, is what you said.
That's like revenge porn. This is revenge pork. I'm feeding all these babies report. That's what the hell we finna do.
And, yeah,
revenge pork.
So luckily, no kid, like, they didn't get sick or anything like that. But now they're trying to, like, fix it. And now they're taking all these precautions with the new food that's coming in. But a worker did discover it. Like a worker in the kitchen, because he's a parent and his kid go to one of these schools. So he like, hold on.
How he know though?
Well, they're marked. It's marked. Oh, 2009.
So somebody wasn't doing their fucking job then. How the fuck?
Because they're marked. Like they said that the date was on there, but like y'all ain't look at y'all just gonna feed him that anyway.
Such bullshit.
So the guy who reported it was like, well, my kids didn't eat it that day, but I, you know, as a parent, I just needed to say something.
See what I'm saying? That's too much.
This you don't. I don't look at the picture. That looks gross. Let me see. Like, look at that shit.
Yeah, that's bad.
That don't even look like meat no more.
That really look like ham.
Like, I don't. I just don't know what that looks
day
like.
Day old ham when you wake up in the morning.
It just looks
after Thanksgiving.
you fucking ham up for me right now. You know that?
I don't eat pork. I stopped eating that swine.
I don't really, 13 years.
I haven't though. And you fucking it up for me.
Oh, you shouldn't eat it anyway.
Well, I want to talk about this man that's been sleeping with these women with no penis. How did you do that?
Damn lie. See, who made this bullshit?
Like, go ahead, B.
A 40-year-old man
with no penis.
Slept with over 100 women.
Slept with 100 chicks.
Okay. With what?
See how
many There's toys out there. Maybe he had like one of them.
No, but he said a lot of women didn't know and they were pissed when they found out. How they don't know though? What you.
I just want to say this. Whatever his name is.
Okay.
That's a G.
This is the P. This is the V. Some gotta go into the V. Like,
I just want to know how he got that bra to the crib.
Like,
he got game.
Okay. You got game. You got it there.
He ain't get it there though. You get it? He ain't get it.
I can't.
Right? He ain't get it there.
He's 40 years old, and he claimed he slept with 100 women. So he said that one chick. Why he go back to like when he was 15 though? Like, oh, I was with this girl for 4 years, and she didn't care. She was a child. Like, no, she didn't care. But grown ass women care. What do you like?
Well, I mean, you know, so, it's a lot.
He's in a strap on. Like, I don't. I'm just confused.
That's what I'm saying. He probably.
So they don't see this. You don't see this man strapping on a fake penis and fucking, like, I just don't get it. How do you get away with it?
No, baby, leave the lights off. Leave the lights off. Leave the lights off.
Let me go to the bathroom real quick. Like, I don't.
Turn over.
He can't get any pleasure, though, because he don't have nothing.
And I feel bad for him because this is a birth defect.
Yeah, I want to know why. What did they say?
He was born this way. It's a birth defect. And now scientists
Are they going to give him a TV show? Because everybody seems like everybody.
That's exactly what's going to happen. I can just tell.
They feel sorry for him.
Yeah, this is what's happening. He's going to be on a show, TLC UK, June 11th, people. But it's in the UK.
Privilege.
So, yeah, he has a show called The Man With No Penis.
That is called Privilege.
But doctors and scientists are constructing the penis for him now. Who? Doctors and scientists are, like, making a penis.
Privilege.
A functional penis.
Let's bring the daddies in the house. Get all of them out of prison.
This is crazy.
Let's see if that works for us. That's a story.
So he gets a show.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
But he don't have no
He ain't got no talent. Literally no talent.
No talent.
He ain't got no talent at all. Now let me see this. Uh-oh.
Okay, so you know, B, how we always say that the most homophobic people are usually gay and in the closet and all that.
Well, clearly.
Right. So, North Dakota.
Well, what's homophobe? I really don't know what homophobe is. Because my comedy is like, you know, like alpha male. So I don't want to.
Right. No, you're an alpha male, but you're not just like an asshole to gay people. Like,
That's what that is.
Yeah, it's like just because someone.
I don't even say they. I'm gonna put them as whatever their name is. The gay community. Them some funny motherfuckers, man. They funny. If you listen,
we have
to
one
them,
in the corner over here. Proud and out. Why are you looking at Tip?
I didn't know.
You didn't know Ron was gay? How?
Because I'd be like, what up, G? I don't, you see what I'm saying?
He's still a real dude from Chicago.
You can tell he's a real dude. I'm just saying, I'm like, what up, G? Like, you know what I'm saying? But my point is, they people, regardless.
You don't have to be like flaming to be gay. as he does a snap over at the wall.
Okay.
All right. So North Dakota State Rep. Randy Boning.
Who? What's his name?
Randy Boning. He's a Republican.
Mm-hmm.
And I love how they say he came out as a member of the LGBT community. No, he was outed.
He was outed, which means he got caught.
He got caught on Grindr. Do you know what Grindr is?
No, I don't. I'm not social media. I don't need. I don't believe in that shit.
Grindr's a man on man dating site.
Yeah, it's a gay dating
gay
app.
Gay dating app.
but gays use it to just fuck.
He was
basically.
Grinding.
It's called Grindr.
It's the isn't it the basis of what Tinder is based
kinda,
off of?
Yeah.
Tinder copy that whole thing.
Okay, kinda. Right.
Some new shit.
So he was on Grindr sending photos and shit. And one of the guys that he sent the photo to outed his ass.
Could you imagine? Now y'all see how all this go with each other, right? Let's just look the three we just had, right? Mm-hmm. We had my man revenge porn, right? And we got the dude with the no move.
Yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. I don't say the word. I
no
say
move,
move,
dude.
Right?
Okay.
He ain't got no move. All right,
all right.
Right? And then we got the GOP dude.
Mm-hmm.
This is awesome.
Because
it's
awesome.
Grindr, right?
Grindr, yes.
Grindr, and we have dude with no move, and then we
and
have
NFL revenge porn.
So he was going through his situation, and his lover got mad and did revenge porn on him.
Well, okay, get this, though. The reason why the guy outed him, he voted against the bill for gays in North Dakota to have equal housing and, like, equal rights. So he voted against that shit. And you're gay? Like, come on, homie. So they're like, so the guy, like, messaged his ass back on Grindr, like, so you don't feel like a hypocrite, homie?
Hey, Ron, do gay people have a term for Uncle Tom? Something similar? Because that's what he is.
That is what he is. Oh, doesn't the hypocrisy bother you is what the guy messaged him. So he didn't message back. So the guy was like, oh, okay, I'm going to out your ass then.
So you see that right there? So you got to be careful.
But he's saying, oh, nobody influenced me to come forward. It has to come out anyway. No, your ass would have kept that secret and been fucking men on the low.
And he was
the
a
whole
powerful
time.
Gay.
Now, what's that called? Now, there is a term for that, right? What's that called?
The fuck?
A dude that's gay, but he pretends like he's not, but he be fucking dudes. You told me this?
DL.
What's trade?
We be trying to teach B,
what's
like,
trade?
All the gay,
Ron told
gay
me the
terms
term, trade.
And everything.
Who? What's that? What's trade, G? What's that?
It's like somebody
like
that
if you were gay, you would be like trade, you still
you don't look gay. Yeah. So it's like you look straight, you mask, you
look
really
gay?
Mask.
No. Oh, he's saying
you
don't fit the stereotypical.
So someone that doesn't fit, yeah, the stereotypical look of a gay guy or act like a gay guy. So you're very manly, you got the beard, you're real alpha male, but you would be gay, and that's trade.
That's why I learned some new
that's
shit
fun.
From
so
every
B,
week, man.
So
that's
B would hilarious. Be trade, you would be trade. We taught B that a while
hell
ago.
Hell no.
So funny.
I feel cultured, man. I like learning this shit.
That nigga said
trade.
I'm
thinking, you know, we should just sing. Y'all should have a DJ in here be like, trade in my life. Fuck, that's
really?
R. Kelly.
R. Kelly? You gonna bring out
back
R.
in the day. Ron know what the fuck I was doing. He know what I was doing. Y'all didn't, but once I said, he was like, oh, I got it. You know what I mean? Go ahead.
Come on, we got two more to get through.
Let me hear.
Go ahead, B.
Family's home gets destroyed by an orgy. After they rented it to, 15 to 20 people? What's Airbnb?
Have you heard of Airbnb?
I saw it on the news.
Yeah,
this
site.
This is shit that was on the news. Yeah, well, yeah, this shit was
it's
big.
It's a new site that's actually really popular where people rent out their houses and apartments to people like vacationing or in town for short periods of time. So like if you even in like another country, so if you go to visit another country, it's cheaper than a hotel, and people may be vacationing themselves, so they're not there, so they rent out
so they rent
their
out
house.
They
yeah.
real house. They,
so that's
not
what
a timeshare.
Airbnb is. And so this family, go ahead, I'm gonna let you do it.
I would never, man.
I would not
rent my house out to nobody. You
no,
fucking kidding me?
I mean, you ain't staying at my house.
Basically, they rented it out to they thought it was a couple people. They came back and it was like 20 motherfuckers in there. Had been fucking all weekend, doing all kinds of wild shit, destroyed the house.
Well, no. It was more than 100 people that, like, partied there.
It was more than 100, but
they found 15 to 20
people when they got back.
Yeah.
Still there, like, they just didn't want to leave and shit.
It's disgusting.
Yeah.
Like,
you know what? That's $62,000 in damages.
Trash, bodily fluids,
right?
Condoms, underwear, right, and broken glass everywhere.
Whoa! So why was they breaking shit?
That's, I mean,
some wild shit, I guess.
Wild shit going on.
I ain't fucking on no broken glass.
Look at the house. Like, that's gross.
Privilege.
But the good thing is Airbnb.
Fucking privilege. That's what that is.
Airbnb has an insurance policy up to $1 million to, you know, ensure that your shit don't get fucked up.
Nah, so their house ain't that messed up now. It ain't $1 million.
$62,000.
Fuck out of here.
That's still... I wouldn't, even after they came and fixed my shit, I still wouldn't feel
gross. Bodily fluids?
You had to move.
Yeah, man.
Gross. I wouldn't be able to touch shit in my, I don't give a fuck how much you disinfect. Oh my God. I can't even.
I would have one of those CSI lights.
I can't. Because look at this toilet. Look at what happened on this toilet. I can't. I can't. I can't go in my bathroom again.
Look at the cushions. That's even worse.
That's worse.
Well, you got to get rid of all your furniture. That's clear. Like, I'm selling the house. Fuck that. I'm not going back in that bitch. Are you crazy?
Because bed bugs is real, ladies and gentlemen.
You get pregnant and don't know why. Shit. You don't know who the baby daddy is.
Dried up babies in the upholstery and shit.
All them embryos. There ain't nothing but embryos in that.
Right. Get the
STDs, bad bugs, shit, is for real, herpes, people living on the top. I can't.
Oh my God.
Bad bugs, all type of shit.
Parasites and bad bugs is real, people.
Yeah. Your face was so
sick. You gotta just, can I just say one more announcement?
What announcement?
Bad bugs are real, ladies and gentlemen. Y'all gotta use dryer sheets.
I can't.
To get rid of the... The bed bugs is real, ladies and gentlemen.
He's so serious right now. That need to be the title of the show. Bed bugs are real.
Real, ladies and gentlemen. Parasites.
And that ain't got shit to do with what we talking right about.
I like it. We going with that.
Man. So this just takes desperation and loneliness to a new fucking level.
Let me hear this one.
So somebody invented the selfie arm. Oh, you heard of the selfie stick,
the
right?
Stick. That's okay, the stick. I know about the stick. Too. I know about the stick.
So you know about the stick because I be seeing people. We were just at an
so
event.
So how do they press the button?
With the selfie.
But they say go?
Oh, wait. No. So the arm has a little attachment at the end of it that holds your phone. And there's like something where you're holding the hand and it takes the selfie. So it looks like you're holding someone's hand and it doesn't make you look alone.
Now you ready? Can I just say,
please,
what
does
say
that hand? Does that hand do anything else?
No.
First, look at this loser ass broad in this picture.
The hand don't even look real. It's like a dead body. Like,
first
why?
Off, I just want to say to the creator of the shitty arm idea. And these motherfuckers really gave this bullshit attention.
Yeah.
And I watched Shark Tank.
Yeah.
And motherfuckers really come up with some
real
ideas. Shit. And
yeah,
this bullshit got,
I agree,
privilege.
I agree. I'm with you there.
Privilege.
Sir.
Is the camera on me?
Yeah. The camera's fucking on all of us.
Privilege. Bullshit. This is bullshit. Fucking privilege.
The selfie arm designed to make you look less lonely. You're,
who the fuck
I can't, there's so many words.
Where your daddy at? Fuck is your father?
And look at her, just looking all
I'm saying.
Psycho and lonely and shit. Bitch, no.
Exactly.
That hand look all dead and cold. Fuck that, no.
You know what she got?
I
bet you we go to her house, she has bed bugs, ladies and gentlemen.
Because they are real.
They are real.
They real. Bed bugs are real.
Parasites. Privilege.
Oh my God. So we don't really have time to get into the other two, but we'll just touch on them.
Why
really
not?
Quick.
Why not?
Because we got another segment to talk about.
Come on, this one is good. Come on, we got to do the father and son.
We'll go into it really quickly. So a father and son duo basically stole $72,000 worth of health and beauty aids.
Where your daddy at and where his real father at? Okay, let's go to the next one.
I can't. This is in Oregon. White people shit. I can't.
I call it the Rose State.
I just can't. So that was that one. And then, so David Rockefeller.
I know who he is.
99 years old. This man is on his, he just had his sixth heart transplant.
He don't want to leave, ladies and gentlemen.
Die, motherfucker. It's time.
He's a billionaire. He ain't trying to go nowhere.
It's time
Rockefeller
to die.
Like, Jay-Z ain't the real Rockefeller, goddamn.
Like, it's time to die.
He don't want to leave, ladies and gentlemen.
You're 99.
He got bed bugs.
6 heart transplants.
He don't want it. Ain't, hey, that's when you, that lets you know it ain't for him.
He started in the 70s getting heart transplants. I'm gonna like, need.
He looked like the
He was out when Falcon Crest was on TV. Murder, She Wrote was invented. What was the other one? Knots Landing, Dallas. Ron, what was back in the shit? Charlie's Angels.
Oh.
Knight Rider.
Knight Rider.
He held free slaves.
He held free slaves.
He held like all of that
he
shit.
He was around the Great Depression.
He was. I can't like.
Nah, he's a Rockefeller. I don't think he was freeing them.
Shit. You sure he wasn't
freeing them.
Where
do you think
he
got that money from?
He's known for his humanitarianism. Yeah, and now. All this other
after
shit.
You done made 500 some billion dollars. Yeah, then you be like, yo, let's free a couple of them niggas.
Oh my God.
A nigga come work for me. Fuck out of here.
Parasites.
6 though.
Yeah. Homie, he don't want to go.
Don't he look like the original
he
vampire?
Dead
no,
right
he look
now.
Like don't Beelzebub.
Yeah.
That's who the fuck he look like, Beelzebub. If you look at him and put up the picture of the
look
liar of all liars.
Look it up.
It's Diablo to the Hispanics.
Why do I tweet that?
To my Latin brothers, Diablo.
I can't.
To the Americans, that's the devil. The liar of all liars. Yeah, that's what.
You're so
that's what. That's what the pastors and them nuts. Say when they look at. They say, "Ha ha! Look at all the liars of all liars." Talking about the devil, Beelzebub.
That's the
and you got to lean in with your chest. You got to be like, "See, you understand? There's a whole bunch of devils out there."
That was the devil voice that you.
Just here.
Oh, that's the pastor.
Rockefeller,
voice.
I rock all fellas. Bedbugs are real.
Can't.
Y'all stupid.
This nigga
you
crazy
stupid.
As fuck.
All right, let's
oh my
go.
God.
Here
okay.
we go.
So I was on, shit. You know I'm always on Facebook,
okay.
social media.
What you get? What you come up with?
Well, I forgot who posted it, but I saw a post about like.
See shit like this?
One of your, one of like the worst jobs in the world, right? So this guy in China, he's a zookeeper, and he had to help a constipated monkey pass a peanut by licking its butt for an hour. That's his job, right? Gross.
And yeah. He got a smile on his face the whole time he's doing it.
This ain't worth my comment.
So wait, wait. Mm-hmm. I saw this posted.
That shit is sick.
So I sent it to B and was like, hey, I think we should do a segment about the worst jobs in the world, and that'll be fun to talk to Grady about.
I think homie got it.
Yeah, because looking at
he's
the
close.
Monkey's ass. Yeah, because they was like, oh, the monkey would die if he didn't. That little motherfucker going to have to die. I'm sorry.
How would.
I'm
see,
sorry. You got to die.
You see what I'm saying? If you look at shit, just listen to shit like that. Let's just really think about that. They want see how inhumane motherfuckers are?
All right, because a human could be dying. You ain't going to lick his ass. You're going to lick a monkey's
what
ass.
What my grandfather and my grandmother taught me, that's white people shit.
That's I say it all the time on the show. White
that's
people
their shit. Mm-hmm. People don't like to give them that. It's like, that's your fucking nasty
what black
shit.
Person, you know, going to lick a monkey's ass?
First of all,
life?
They gonna, how they going to lick monkey's ass and they came and got the other monkeys 400 some years ago.
Look at this.
Sinke, give us free. That they call us monkeys?
Yeah.
All
yeah.
right then. Now they go, I wish that, man, get the fuck
oh
out of
here. He mad right now. He mad.
Get the fuck out of here.
So I
devil.
Found other mm-hmm. horrible jobs in the
oh,
world.
Oh, let me see this.
So that we can talk about that. Now this you got right
here.
All right.
Here, all right, bet. Okay. Okay.
So this is like, they call it the top worst jobs in the world. You know it's some shit worse than this, but we can just dive into it. So I did hear that the guard, being a guard at Buckingham Palace is quite fucking horrible because, you know, they have to stay stone faced. Like they can't make a they can't like have emotions or like react to things. So people do all type of fucked up shit to them.
So who come up with, how did they know? Did they ask the guards?
No, is it's your, just no. Like if you're in London and you visit, like
no, I'm saying
know.
Did the guards say their job was worse? Did the guards say
oh,
it?
I don't know who came up
but
with this
then we
list.
Can't,
but
see, stop fucking lying.
Okay, but think about it. Think about it. Think about it.
Okay.
Because you would knock the fuck out of somebody. But if it's your job to just
stand
there and you
depending
can't do shit.
Depending on what the bread is.
People do all, but you know, people do like spit in their face and shit. Like, people do crazy shit to these people and they can't do shit. They got to stand there.
Well, my publicist had me on red carpets and I didn't really like a third of them motherfuckers there. She made me take pictures
and smile.
And now, they want to do none of that. Where the bread at? Where that fucking bread at? Where the show at? Let's do that first.
Oh my God.
But, you know, I don't know. That would, I mean, to me, that's just showing structure, and
yeah,
that's part of the
it's
monarchy.
It's not the word. I mean, well, I don't know. I can't speak on
what they call it. Monarchy. What's the
monarchy?
Monarchy. That's part of their shit. They know. Oh, now hey, did I see that? Right?
Yeah, portable toilet cleaner.
Well, when I used to work in hazmat, I used to work in hazmat before I started telling jokes full time. We would have to. It's a dipper meter, right? And you could touch the knob, the handle,
mm-hmm.
and it'll read any color, and it'll tell you how many species of bacteria that's on the handle.
Ugh, gross.
So I could just imagine
in a porta potty
is it's I want to say at least 1,000 some species of bacteria. As soon as you go in, it doesn't even it's airborne. You don't even know it. You don't even realize. And the sickest shit that I ever seen. This is a movie called North Country. What's the, I always mess her name up. She bad as shit. What's that chick? Charlize.
No, Theron, yeah.
I always call her Thezrin. And my manager, Tiff, would be like,
That ain't her name at all.
So.
Thezrin.
The movie is called North Country, and it's a coal miner's joint. So, you know, that's an alpha male job, okay? Women don't dig rocks,
right.
Okay? But she did. She want to get equal treatment and all that other, you know, sick shit. And then, they treated her so bad, and they pushed her over, and all that shit came out
homie.
On her.
We ain't gonna do that.
Even though it wasn't real, but because I've been in hazmat, that's some nasty shit.
No.
Because you can, you know, you've been to a, well, let's say, like, if fecal matter was.
That's on here.
Okay.
Something like
but
that.
But you can, if someone had fecal matter, and you just, like, if it was a pile, and you just put your hand next to it. That'll get on you.
Yeah, I don't.
It'll start to eat your flesh. Yeah, that shit real. There's no joke. Don't fuck with doo-doo. Okay, let's,
Roadkill remover. Dead-ass animals just in the street.
Well, first of all.
That can't be the worst, though.
Why would
that ain't even close.
Why
it's gross,
why
but
he
like.
Why he paint the motherfucker? He painted over the animal. Show it to Ron. Ron, wait till you. They painted over the animal with the dog.
With the lines
for the street. Oh, instead of picking them up, they just said, fuck them. Ron, they said, fuck them, Ron.
Just the line.
Yeah, just put a line over them. Somebody, I ain't picking that motherfucker up.
So, flattest odor judge.
Oh, shit.
Two brave souls that have to smell people's farts.
Yeah.
See, it ain't nothing but methane gas anyway.
It says 16,
eat some McDonald's.
16 healthy individuals volunteered to eat pinto beans and insert small plastic collection tubes into their behinds. And then someone has to smell.
So this is white people shit, man.
Because who doing that?
They bored.
Why? But why? Why we got to do
you
that?
You see how you know they at the top of the shit? We don't have time to smell people's asses.
We ain't doing that.
Lick farts.
Like, no. That's disgusting.
Okay, whatever.
A Brazil mosquito researcher.
See, that's some slave shit. There's slaves in Brazil. That's what we
have.
Yeah,
it's true.
Right? Okay.
This is for scientists that are trying to fight malaria in those types
of
countries.
So we gonna say Britain ain't got no goddamn mosquitoes? Who came up with the name? It sure ain't the Brazilians.
I can't.
Somebody lying to us?
So you got scientists sitting there basically getting fucked up by these damn mosquitoes that could carry malaria, and they're trying to find like a cure for
But they won't get malaria. They only get malaria when they go to West Africa, Ghana. Shout out to the Ivory Coast.
Apparently in Brazil too. I ain't doing that either.
Not at all.
Animal masturbator.
No, you miss one.
Uh-uh. Janitor at a porno theater.
Nah, that ain't no bad. Well, it depends on who touches
it. What you cleaning? I was going to say bodily fluids. We talked about this.
Well then.
Gross.
Let's do the animal. Hey, now.
So wait, what's an animal masturbator?
You know what that means.
No.
He beat off the animal.
They beat the animals off instead of the sperm.
But, So like a big ass elephant penis? Because that's what they're showing, right?
No, that's a rhino.
That's a rhino. That is disgusting.
People, well, I just tell you like this. Can I just, I like too. To share, because I watch animals. I'm a big animal dude. When they doo-doo, you see that little towel? They flick it. And they just throw shit everywhere.
That noise. He just,
they just stand there and
that's
shit.
How Dookie,
and,
that's how Dookie
flies. When they do it, the tail go back and forth. It's like, they're very gross. Yep, hippos, they shit like them. I don't want to masturbate.
This one makes me throw up in my mouth right now. Cat food quality tester.
White people
Okay. I grew up in a household with a cat. Just like serving him his cat food.
It pissed you off?
I always gag because that smell alone with the cat food was gross.
Well, the new cat food is...
but to taste it? Why? A human got to taste this shit?
Mel Gibson did it in the movie. He ate the dog bone and leaked the weapon. See? White people shit.
But cat food, have you seen
cat food?
Wet, gross ass cat food.
Nah, what they what
dog food and cat food to me pretty much is the same shit.
What they do is they have somebody, they try to make it as close to human food as possible.
Yeah.
Because humans are the ones buying the shit. You know what I'm saying? So
you're a smart dude, B.
That's why they do it.
I'm jealous. I should have thought of that first. I'm so jealous right now.
I can't.
Manure inspector. Come on. That's a good one.
Wow, we cool.
So, okay, this was the elephant. I'm like, I know I saw an elephant. So, an elephant basically take this big-ass dump. You standing behind him in his asshole, and you got a bag, and you catching it. And then you got to go and inspect it for, like, E. coli and shit like that.
Yeah, they do it for a lot of different species, though, depending on where they are.
Well, that's why I don't go to the goddamn circus, because I can tell it stinks in there.
You can tell.
You can tell.
Now, this is what I did. But go ahead.
Sewers cleaner?
Oh, yeah. That's no joke. That's all hazmat.
You did this?
You did that shit?
What?
Oh,
that was my first. That was my first month with hazmat.
Oh.
So they call it a septic tank. So you see that right there? That's a septic tank right there.
Look at the poor person in there. Oh, my God.
No, 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 no.
That's what he's saying.
He's in a different country.
Oh, yeah.
In the United States, he would have to have on a Tyvek suit. And a scuba gear for the way, what we had to do was, you know, scuba tanks. You had to unscrew the valve, put the tank. I mean,
because at least
suit
you
on.
Have a suit on. He don't have on shit.
And then you fill. You just hold the air and just press up the turn up the PSI, pounds per square inch, and it'll fill up your suit, right? Fill up your whole suit. So really, so what happens is that guy right there. That just depends on how far from the main line is from this line here. This is a neighborhood. So the main junction is about 350 yards. 350 yards, so you go 300 feet until you accumulate all of that. And then he has 5 minutes of air in that suit. So let's say if he's claustrophobic and he's like, oh, blow your shit.
So you just wasted the 5 minutes.
No, you just got to work. See, that's... But
he don't have on shit though. Like he don't have on.
He ain't even got on a shirt.
Well, he don't even have a hat. Like nothing. He just in the sewer.
That's
and right.
Naked.
Yeah. Now, what I
he
did.
He's in human waste and shit. Like
yeah,
I can't.
That's for real. No, that's no joke right there.
That's gross. That's so joke. You know, the next time y'all complain about y'all job and you
stop
know you think you got it bad, you don't.
You ain't cleaning shit and holding elephant doo doo. And licking the goddamn monkey ass all the goddamn time. And you ain't gonna sit around here and be kissing my ass all day, you goddamn banana lover. And you gonna sit around here and fuck with mosquitoes.
Oh,
and I'm trying to tell somebody, don't you put the goddamn raid in the house because your mama won't open up the goddamn window because somebody done farted on here. And who gonna sit up here and clean the goddamn toilet stool? You done let 50 niggas come here and fuck all up under the goddamn in the kitchen. I can't even know if it's ice cubes or real nut inside my ice cube.
I can't.
Goddamn heathen nigga babies right there.
Heathen nigga babies. Nope.
Sister come from, she looking like she just got in from Bangladesh. Smelling like a goddamn nigga loving monkey eater.
I can't.
Y'all stupid.
The fact that he just took all our stories though and put them in one.
You okay, B?
Where y'all find this?
I don't know.
That was all material. That's material,
I
boy.
I don't know. Where
a comic, we
from.
Like, oh, this is material. I found out. And you know what? And your brother, guess what he is? He a goddamn trade nigga. See what he is? He a trade nigga. That's what my man Ron told me. That's a joke. I'm going to make that shit hot. Watch what I tell you.
Wait, how about Tone Bell was here writing shit down. And he was like, can I take these notes with me? We like, you can take whatever you want. I'm taking mine, though.
Tiff, shout out to my man.
You doing shit that came out from this show on stage.
Take the pen and put trade on. Can I see your pen?
I ain't got one.
So real quick.
Okay, come on.
We got to wrap up.
Let's go.
Tell everybody about the show again. Where is it? E1, right?
E1.
In Oakland.
In Oakland. Bay Area. Comedy Club. Shout out to Oakland, Sacramento. What else is up there?
I ain't familiar with the Bay.
The show.
I don't think Sacramento is.
Yeah, that's still a Bay.
That's the Bay?
Yeah, that's still a Bay.
Because it's an hour away.
Yeah. E1, myself, Ballhead, Hustle Phillips out of Chicago, Nick Carthan, Takara Carthan, hosted by the Bay's own Jay Rich. You know, he's funny. He's funny. Yeah, he wear hats like you. Your hat you got on, he hilarious. He like a light-skinned Cedric Entertainer, but he young. You know what I'm saying? He young in the game. Hungry hog, nigga. You know what I mean? He funny. He go get it.
Are you doing new material?
Well, the people that was, they want to see the shit that I did
that
for
you
the
did
Shaq
before,
shit.
Yeah.
You know, I was like, nah, I got some shit. Like, nah, nigga.
We won't.
I want to hear that shit you did because we really didn't hear it all. You know, everybody was laughing. You know, that's how shit be.
Well, people seem excited. I wish we could make it, but we cannot.
Yeah, I can't wait, though. You know what I mean? This is going to kick it off. This is going to be a special show for me.
And it's just one night, right? Saturday?
Just one night, Saturday night, 8 o'clock. We're going to have some fun for
Bay
two
Area.
Hours.
Come on out,
yeah,
E1.
Yeah, E1. Yeah, we're going to have a ball. We're going to have a ball. What else am I supposed to say?
Tell everybody where to find you.
Oh, okay.
How to connect with you on social media.
Check me
everything.
On your next comedy club or your theater. Next, Ray Grady.
Grady
Facebook.
Comedy.
Ray Grady.
He don't be remembering
his shit. Instagram.
Grady Comedy.
Grady Comedy.
Twitter, Grady Comedy.
Grady Comedy.
RayGrady.com.
Oh, yeah, RayGrady.com.
And, I can't.
And, yeah, check me at your, local grocers.
At the local grocery.
Yeah, I don't know what it is about Trader Joe's. I just like walking in there. I don't want to buy shit. I just want to walk in there. I love
why this fool, let me in real quick before.
Go ahead, Bill, tell him.
He
shit.
Bought me some wine called Raymond.
You think, hey, I'm cold. Trader Joe's. I was like, hey.
I
got
can't.
The perfect
it was good
gift
ass
for.
Wine, though. I ain't gonna
it was
front.
Good?
It was good. I ain't gonna front.
Okay, bet.
You know, I love me some wine.
Yes, sir. I mean, yes, ma'am. Not sir, but you know what I mean?
But anyway, it's always.
I appreciate
pleasure.
Y'all having me, man. Hopefully, I want to come back, man.
Oh, you know you always.
I gotta come back. I want to make this like my home. That's
you're
seat
always
right,
welcome.
That's my seat right
misconduct.
There. So have somebody over sit there. That chair over here.
Okay.
He can't sit in that seat because that's my seat.
That's
right
your
there.
Seat. Yeah, all yeah. right.
No, I appreciate it, y'all, for real.
Oh my God. So as usual, follow us on socialmisconduct.com where you can get all of our information. We'll be sending out newsletters soon if you miss any of our shows. Follow us on Twitter at Social Misconduct, Instagram Social Misconduct, Facebook Social Misconduct Radio. Anything else before we wrap up?
Are you doing something?
We have an event, a Indian restaurant grand opening coming up on Thursday in Beverly
really?
Hills. So, yeah, we'll check that out. We'll see. We did a Scion event last week, right? Mm-hmm. So that was pretty cool for entrepreneurs. And we posted pictures and everything on all our social
shout
media.
Shout out to the
so.
Chick that broke the toilet.
Okay, shout out to her
because
she's
the
important.
She was.
Anything else important before we leave?
That shit was pretty important. Motherfuckers was waiting for a while.
What did she do? We gotta go.
She tore it up? Blew it up like the elephant.
Anyway, same place, same time next week. Peace out.
You're listening to Social Misconduct with Mik and B. Walt, only on LA Talk Radio.